there is a spiritual war that is going on, where when we worship, we enter into that spiritual war, and we're fighting in worship right there on the battlefield. So just keep praying. Don't stop. Mm-hmm. And grab a partner. Where two or three are gathered, grab some people to pray with you. Go ahead.
And I wanted to chime in, because both of them said what I was going to say, but something else hit me. Then another one, you know, that was good that they both grabbed it, you know. But a third one came to mind that they both didn't grab, so I appreciate it. If they didn't grab it, I appreciate it. The Lord brought back to my mind that, as Sister Monica said, you got to switch up the lines of communication. And Sabria said, sometimes you got to press on in and keep on praying. And even grab a prayer partner, which is what we did. And, you know, real quick, I pray that it went well for everybody. I heard it went well. It went well for me for the 10 days. And I pray we can do it again. And for those of you who didn't know, I just want to throw out there, we teamed up with somebody, and you prayed with them every day for 10 days. It could be 5 minutes, 6 minutes. You prayed with somebody every day. And we had some awesome testimonies
last time. That's good.
So I pray we can do it again. If you guys like it, we can do it again.
Yeah.
But the thing I wanted to bring out, based on those two great examples they gave, is that sometimes, like Sabrina said, God, you pray and God has released the answer, but sometimes we can become disobedient to what God has already given. Case in point, in dealing with Samuel and Eli, God had already told Eli what he needed to do. He didn't deal with his two sons.
Oh, yeah.
So communication, sometimes it could be, it ain't under siege, just that you didn't take the communication that was given the first time. And so now everything's under siege. You don't know what's going on. The people don't know what's going on. When in fact, you didn't forgot the message that was given to you weeks ago. You didn't delete the message. You didn't ball it up and threw it in the trash. And now everybody else confused. They don't know what's going on. Yeah, man, I don't know what's going on. Your eyes are getting dim. You don't know what's going on. Eli was getting old. He was getting old. He didn't know what was going on. And he got so old, he kept missing that. I don't know, you know. And he didn't deal with it. So God had to raise up Samuel.
That's right.
So sometimes God has already given the answer. Mm-hmm. But if you not go, if you done threw the message away, because sometimes we don't like what God done said. We don't like the answer. We want something that feel good and tastes good.
That's true.
But then sometimes God's got to, if it's a donkey, or if it's a bird, or whether it's a little child, God will raise up somebody.
Come on.
To let you know, I'm doing this because I told you what I was going to do, and you didn't deal with it. So this is what's going to happen to you. You don't want that. You want to take the, I got the message, I don't like it. Let me deal with my sons. Because you look at the world now, you got a lot of wild kids nowadays. How many people didn't deal with the message they got the first time? Now I got to deal with them in school. I deal with bad ones. You know what I'm saying? So I deal with the bad ones. Because I'm a teacher, I've been in education for 7 years. And the communication, people threw it away. And now the society now has to take up and deal with things that should have been dealt with a long time ago. So that's another thing that we have to make sure that when God gives the communication, that we don't ball it up and throw it away and act as if God didn't say something. Because then it causes other people to suffer who may not never have had to suffer had we dealt, because then the people didn't know what was going on. But if he would have dealt with it, the people would have known what was going on. And God would have gave clear instructions for the next one. I'll leave you with this last thing. Dave Hollis, I'll never forget, the preacher, gave a message where he talked about that sometimes God will give you, and I'm paraphrasing, will give you an instruction, and he's not going to give you another instruction until you follow the first instruction that he gave you. So you have to be obedient to that instruction, because you don't know who it may affect.
That's right.
And so I want to leave that with that.